Hi, we're Pastors Jerry and Julie Jenkins, Addiction Free in Christ, a ministry of miracles. And this whole TV program, speakers meeting program, and aftercare program is all about freedom from addiction. So today we're going to be talking about how you can be totally set free if you're struggling with anxiety, worry, fear, depression, no matter what's going on in your life. The last three programs we talked about something, and that is, who do we really love? You know, we love many things in this world we get involved in that we really, we love a basketball team, a football team, a baseball team, a special sport, whatever the case is. Also, was asking this, where do you spend most of your time? What do you spend most of your time thinking about today? Is it your addiction? Is it something out of your past? Is it something you want? So today we're going to be talking about that. And if you have a question you'd like to contact us with and ask us about some of these things we're talking about, you can call us at area code 217-617-5577. So today let's talk about, who do we really love? Well, what's my focus on daily? Well, what am I constantly living for? That's a good question. What are we living for? You know, is it to make more money? Is it to gain a place in society? Is it to a better home, a better vehicle, a better career? What are we actually living for? You know, we were put on this earth for one reason and one reason only, and that was to love God, to communicate with God. And the thing of it is, there's so many things in the world that can completely draw us away. In fact, the Bible talks about the last hours we're living in, and just before Jesus returns, and it says, in the last days, perilous times will come, for men will be lovers of themselves. And that's what we're seeing today. Perilous times, by the way, the Greek word for perilous means ragingly insane. And that's what we're seeing on our TV every day when we look at the news. People are today absolutely becoming ragingly insane. Some young kid, 17, 18 years old, wakes up one morning and decides, I'm going out and kill 20 or 30 people. You know, things we can't even believe are going on. We're in a very, in fact, a lot of us believe we're in the very last seconds of the last hours. When you see what's going on in Israel right now, we could be there. What's going on with Iran right now? I tell you, we're living in troubled times. And our focus has to be on God Almighty. He's the only answer.
Amen.
In fact, Jesus knew that we was going to have this problem. In fact, after he got raised from the dead, he was on the earth and he was walking along one morning and he was out walking along the seashore and he saw the disciples out there fishing. And he thought, I'm going to just stop and cook breakfast for them. This was just before he was raised from the dead and before he was taken up into heaven. He was still on the earth. And so he got some kindling and he started a fire and he cooked some fish for them. And they were so excited. They came in and there's the master. There's their savior. He's alive. And they were jumping up and down. They didn't know what to do. Boy, a time of fellowship they were going to have like they'd never had before. And they sat down and they started eating breakfast and they were just having a wonderful time. And they're all visiting and pretty soon Jesus stopped them, and it's registered in John 15, or John 21, 15, by the way, through 17. And after they'd eaten breakfast, Jesus said to Simon, son of Jonah, do you love me more than these? Do you love me more than these guys you fish with every day? Do you love me more than what you do for a life, or your livelihood? I know you love fishing. Do you love me more than that? Do you love me more than these guys that you spend all your time with every day? Do you love me more than these? Well, he said to him, yes, Lord. Simon said, yes, Lord, you know I love you. And Jesus gave him an order. He said, feed my lambs. And he said to him the second time, Simon, son of Jonah, do you love me? And he said to him, yes, Lord, you know I love you. And he said, tend to my sheep. Well, it goes on to say, verse 17, and he said to him the third time, Simon, son of Jonah, do you love me? And it grieved Peter. And he said, Lord, you know all things. You know I love you. And he said, feed my sheep. And that's what Addiction Free in Christ is all about. Addiction Free in Christ is about we love you more than anything else in the world. We love God more than anything else in the world. We're here serving him. But he loves you more than anything else in the world. And we're here to share that love with you. If you're struggling with an addiction, and I don't care what it is, whether it's alcohol or other drugs, sexual pornography addiction, eating disorder, gambling, smoking addiction, the list goes on and on and on. Whatever you're struggling with, we're here for you. Not to judge you, not to condemn you. That's what the world does every day to us. We're here because we love you. And we're here for you. And if you have a problem, we want you to get involved in this program. We want you to call us. If you're watching on Channel 16, pick up the phone and call us. If you're watching our YouTube channel somewhere in the United States, pick up the phone and call us. Or they can email us. Julie, how can they get a hold of us on the email?
Sure, you can email us at RevJerry@addictionfreeinchrist.com. It's on your screen. Or visit our website that gives you all this contact information at www.addictionfreeinchrist.com. You know, it's interesting when you read John 21, how Jesus reinstated Peter three times after Peter had denied him, three times before Jesus was crucified and paid for our sins. Jesus rose from the dead and then reinstated Peter. You know, some of you may need reinstatement with the Lord.
Oh,
maybe God wants to make a change in your life so that you'll be reinstated with the Lord. Maybe you denied him in front of friends or denied him when you went to and started using alcohol somewhere at some establishment. It may have been a reputable establishment. My point is this, God wants to reinstate you and be one in your life and be the number one in your life because he won't have any other gods before him. He makes that so very clear throughout all of Scripture. And Jesus said, if you abide in him, you'll bear much fruit. And the fruit in Galatians 5:22, what is the fruit of the Spirit? It says in Galatians 5:22, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. And it says against such things there is no law, because the law condemns those who are lawbreakers. But the fruit of God, if you're walking in the Spirit, you're free in regard to these things because you're walking at one with the Lord. So let me get back to the fact that God wants to restore your life. He wants to make that restoration moment in your life. And, you know, you don't have to go back to that old alcohol or those old friends. For affirmation, you need to make new friends. You need to get into a church home. I would recommend you call us and we can connect you with other believers in the Lord who will help you in your walk in sobriety.
Amen. Amen. And so no matter where you are, whether you're watching this on Channel 16, whether you're watching it at a speaker's meeting, whether you're watching it in one of our aftercare programs, all you have to do is pick up the phone and contact us. There's something else that I want to share with you. It says in Galatians, though, Julie. Galatians 6:1 said this, if any man is overtaken by any trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness, considering yourself lest you also be tempted. Bear one another's burdens and fulfill the law of Christ. What Addiction Free in Christ is all about is helping you. We've all been where you've been. This is 33 years that I've been helping people find freedom because I was right where you are one time. I was a serious alcoholic. I struggled with many addictions. Julie had some problems. We're not here to judge or condemn anyone. And if you're watching this on a YouTube channel, if you're watching this in the speaker's meeting and you have questions, or if you're watching it on Channel 16 and you have questions, I want you to just pick up the phone and call us because we're here to help you. We're not here to judge. We're not here to condemn. We're here to help you find what we've found. and that is total freedom through our Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says, if the Son make you free, you shall be free indeed. That's what John said, or the Gospel of John said, 8:36. And then Jesus said, if you abide in my word, you're my disciples indeed, and you'll know the truth, and the truth will make you free. You see, it's the word of God that sets us free. It's not any program. I can't set you free. Julie can't set you free. I couldn't even set myself free because I tried everything and nothing worked until finally one day I surrendered my life to Jesus Christ. And then out of his love and grace and mercy, he lifted me up and he absolutely set me free. He took the desire for alcohol away. He took the desire for gambling away. He took the desire for smoking away. I didn't quit. And a lot of programs have you working one day at a time to accomplish sobriety or whatever it is. Well, you don't need one day at a time. You need 1 second with Jesus Christ. And you need 1 second where you just surrender to him and say, Jesus, I can't do this. I've tried. I just humble myself before you, and I ask you today, just please forgive me. Once you do that, it's a done deal. And what he'll do is take the desire away. The thing you couldn't stop and the thing you couldn't quit doing, he will take that desire completely away. You'll never have the desire to pick up another cigarette, take another drink, look at another piece of pornography, or whatever the case may be. It's something we couldn't do that he does. You see, and that's why this program works. It's different than any other program. Other programs work you through a process where you have to do this and you have to do that. You don't have to do anything except surrender to Jesus Christ. And he will totally set you free. Then once you've done that, we're here to help you to grow in the Lord. We're here to help you. Have you got questions about the Bible? We're here to explain those questions to you. What does the Bible, when the Bible says this, what does it mean? Because sometimes people reading the Bible today just don't understand it. Well, that's what this program's all about. We're here to help you understand. And so there's no stupid question, believe me. I've asked a lot of questions in my life. The only way we learn is by asking questions and then listening. Listening to someone who's trying to help us understand what we need to do to totally be free. So I encourage you today, if you need help, give us a call. That number again is 617-557-5577. That's 217-617-5577. And we'll be glad to talk to you, help you work through whatever you're going through. If it's just anxiety, worry, fear, and depression, that's fine. That's what we're here for. Jesus loves you right where you are, no matter what's going on. The Bible says, trust in the Lord with all your heart, lean not to your own understanding, and he shall direct your ways. And so we're counting on you to do that.